What's up?
Helicobacter pylori is a bacteria that lives in the stomach. Helicobacter pylori can cause formation of gastric ulcers or duodenal ulcers. So it's important for us to determine if Helicobacter pylori is present or not. Because if present, we should prescribe treatment to kill Helicobacter pylori, so-called Helicobacter pylori eradication treatment. Helicobacter pylori test is based on ability of Helicobacter pylori to degrade urea molecules, which is possible because Helicobacter pylori has a specific enzyme called urease. And urease provides degradation of urea molecule to carbon dioxide and to ammonia molecules, and then we determine the amount of carbon dioxide molecules in the breath.
Alright, you like this.
So to explain this, here we have three major compartments, its stomach, blood and lungs. And in the stomach located Helicobacter pylori. And as we know, Helicobacter pylori has a specific enzyme called urease. So to assess the amount of Helicobacter pylori in the stomach, we give to a patient a solution with the urea. But it's not a simple urea, it's a urea molecules with radio-labeled carbon. And when such urea molecules enters into the stomach, Helicobacter pylori by urease enzyme degrades urea into two ammonia molecules and carbon dioxide with radio-labeled carbon. And then we absorb ammonia molecules and carbon dioxide into the blood. And in the blood, carbon dioxide goes into the lungs capillaries. And in the capillaries, carbon dioxide is removed from the blood by exhalation. And because it's carbon dioxide with radio-labeled carbon, we can assess the amount of carbon dioxide molecules in the breath. As we see basically, by assessment of radio-labeled carbon dioxide molecules in the breath, we can say how many Helicobacter pylori organisms are present in the stomach. So the amount of radio-labeled carbon dioxide in the breath is directly proportional to the amount of Helicobacter pylori bacteria in the stomach. Because if there are many Helicobacter pylori bacteria, then there is a massive amount of urease in the stomach. And massive amount of urease results in massive hydrolysis of urea into radio-labeled carbon dioxide and ammonia. Then we absorb into the blood this massive amount of carbon dioxide molecules, and as a result, we exhale significantly high amount of radio-labeled carbon dioxide. So the more invaded is the stomach by Helicobacter pylori bacteria, the higher the amount of radio-labeled carbon dioxide molecules in the air that we exhale. So high values of radio-labeled carbon dioxide is a marker of a massive invasion by Helicobacter pylori.
Now what?
And if Helicobacter pylori is absent, there will be no urease enzyme. Without urease, there will be no hydrolysis of the urea molecules. So urea molecules remain untouched. As a result, ammonia and carbon dioxide are not produced. So there will be no radio-labeled carbon dioxide in the breath. Instead, we absorb untouched urea molecules into the blood, and then excrete urea molecules by the kidneys into the urine. So without Helicobacter pylori, radio-labeled carbon dioxide is not produced, and absence of radio-labeled carbon dioxide in the breath is considered as a negative result of a breath test, which means you are perfectly fine.
Okay. Fine. Yep. Ciao!
What's that mean?
Ciao.
It's Italian. It means food.